A very good evening to all the faculties, my colleagues and friends. Sorry for the maybe long technical delay in the start. The point is actually where I am staying, there is a serious internet issue. So if you are using few technology tools, it is a little bit difficult to get connected. Anyhow, sorry for this technical delay. At the outset, I would like to congratulate Dr. Somu for initiating this kind of an activity where many teacher educators, teacher trainees are joining and exchanging their ideas. I would also like to express my sincere gratitude and thanks to Dr. Somu for inviting me to this lecture. Friends, we haven't met like personally, me and Dr. Somu. Our only connection is through social media. Maybe we can say this is very easy that way to get connected with people through social media, but this is also one of the important features, facilities what social media is offering to the people. I am Ajit Kumar. I am from IGNO. My colleague Dr. Gaurav is also there. Few other colleagues are also watching this live session. Friends, today I will be talking about the social media tools. I know many of us, all the people are using the social media, starting from the WhatsApp to the Facebook. Then there is a whole big list of social media which we can see. Then is there something very new in this presentation? This is a question which I also ask myself. So I have prepared this presentation in such a way that I would be able to give some kind of inputs in the social medias that are available. I'm not touching upon all the social media tools, but the very popular tools which I'll be discussing. With this introductory note, I am sharing my presentation. Friends, when we are talking about the social media, few things we need to have some basic understanding. One is the technological development, web developments. तो ये शुरू किया web 1.0 से. Web 1.0 क्या होता था? There was the facility only to read whatever we are seeing in the website, in the internet. As you see in the slide or a screen, see a person sitting in front of a computer, he is reading whatever it is appearing in the computer screen. Then came a facility where the audience can also give some kind of input to the system, to the internet or to the world wide web, which we call the web 2.0. So the social media tools that we are using, it's pretty simple. This belongs to the web 2.0 technologies, which is some maybe when we are counting the year of its start, it may take us back to maybe some 20-30 years back. Thereafter, web 3.0 came, where you can see as in the slide, a part of our human body, human is into the technology, into the website. Then the whole lot of technological inventions, interventions came into when we talk about web 4.0, web 5.0. Now it's very difficult to separate whether it is a man or whether it is a technology. We are a technology. At the same, technology is a human being. That way maybe we can say, in a funny way we can say, that's what we are seeing. Right now we are experiencing, like when we are sending a mail, if you are writing the email ID of the person whom we are sending, then automatically the email Gmail ID will list out dear so and so name. So this is the kind of a technology that we are now coming up, which are already there in the digital world. There are a big list of technology which can be added to this list. So when we are talking about the social media tools, we have to remind that it's about the web 2.0 technologies, and we have traveled so far after the web 2.0 technologies. What is this actually social media? There are three things which I would like to quote. One is, it will help us to create, then share the content, and also to participate in social networking. So with this is the point which I would like to make when I'm making a presentation of social media. Otherwise, all the social media are very popular and people are already using that. So I would like to restrict my lecture into the social media, wherein which as teachers, as teacher trainees, we use social media for majorly three things. One, to create content. The other is to disseminate, to share the content that we have created. And the final one is to make some social connections to create some social, what we call the networks, wherein which the topics that are related to our realm of work will be discussed So that's how we have to take social media in a digital world, especially by the teachers and students. So in that case, how we look at all the social medias, for example, WhatsApp is a major mode of communication. Whether we can use that facilities in our teaching learning process, then that will be the practical side of social media in the teaching learning process. So we have to look at the social media in that context, where I would focus on three things. One is to create content and disseminating that content, and finally making groups where the problems, the activities which are related to teaching learning can be discussed. Now see, what are the benefits? Benefits are, there are many, many benefits. When we are talking about social media, there are many benefits which we don't have to discuss in a detailed way. But some of the things, like it is very flexible, you can access it anytime. Then there's a big list of benefit that we can relate to social media. And as a teacher, and since it is a pandemic situation, what all things can be shared through the social medias? The prominent tool or the technology that we can use is the video lecture. So we can use the social media tools to what we call delivering the lecture, which of course this is one of the practical application of that. The teacher educators group has come up and they have devised something like they will give lectures on various topics which will be benefited by the huge community. So in that way, we can use the social media to share our video lecture. Then lecture notes can be shared, text materials can be shared, assignments, web links, and there is a, as I said, relating to the what we call the social media, the benefits, there is a big list of things which we can connect to what when we are discussing about what all things can be shared through social media. And this is what is happening right now. There are many things teachers used to share to their students. Now your role as a teacher is very important here. Why? Because as I said in the beginning, there is a big list of social media tools, and we ourselves get confused. Isme kaun sa use karna hai? So your role as a teacher educator, as a teacher, is to identify the popular tool that will be working best for your purpose. See, for small students, like those who are studying in what we call the primary or lower class student, for those students, social media, some of the social media will not be working in a bigger way. So in that case, we don't have to use the social media. But there are instances for higher education, we can definitely use the social media. We can take advantage of the social media. In that case, we have to definitely opt for social media. So your role as a teacher educator, as a teacher trainee, whoever is into the teaching learning process, their role is to I mean, like identify the best social media tools which is available, which will help the teacher to what we call disseminate and create content, and also to, you know, create the social networks. So we have to be very careful when choosing. There are you know, many tools. Some are using Facebook, some are using YouTube, many are using the WhatsApp, some are using tools like Tumblr, then Blogger. So this is up to the teacher, you know, to select the best and the popular tool which is available. Now coming to the list of social media. So as I said in the beginning, my presentation will be restricting only to the popular social media tools. Few social media tools, maybe 20 or 22, which you are seeing in the slide. Because you know, there is no point in, I mean, like giving a big theoretical lecture on all the social media tools, but let us restrict ourselves to some of the popular tools and let us use those tools for our teaching learning purposes. Otherwise we will be, you know, ending up in a big mess and will be confused. So as you see in the slide, these are the tools which I am going to discuss, which of course many teachers, many teacher educators, many educational organizations are already using. Now coming to the what we say, the usage of social media tools. In the slide you can see Facebook and YouTube, you know, list in the number one position. So when we are ranking mein humko Facebook ko sabse pehle dikha sakta hai, then YouTube is there. This I have taken from a website which is doing a frequent survey on the social media tools. So they have listed Facebook as one of the popular media tools. Maybe it can be related to the, you know, a general audience, but this is almost true in the case of the teaching learning industry also. Many of the teachers, educational organizations, they are using Facebook, YouTube. So if you are ranking that way, maybe these are the two tools which come in the front position or in the rank 1 and 2. Even there is a website called Center for Learning and Professional Development, Center for Learning and Performance Technologies. Even those websites also list YouTube as the most popular tool which is used by the teachers and students. Use YouTube as the most popular tool. Now, so I'll be restricting, as I said, I'll be restricting my lecture to that famous tools only. And I'll be discussing how we can use these tools. Few people are already using, but I would like to give some kind of, you know, information which I have. This is nothing a big deal about creating a Facebook account. Now, there are 3-4 ways by which this Facebook technology can be used by the teachers or teacher educators. One of the ways is creating a web page or Facebook page. Usually pages are created by those who have, you know, having a huge fan followers. In that way, celebrities like film stars, politicians, they make Facebook pages to get connected with their huge number of fans. Even this Facebook page can be also created by the teachers in our teaching learning process, because if in some of the institutions, like if it is a ODL institution, open university, in that case the number of students will be large. In that case, if you want to get connected with your students, you can create, as teachers, you can create a Facebook page, and then you can deliver the lectures through Facebook. You can, you know, disseminate, share your educational content. So this is one of the, you know, options the teachers can make use of by creating a Facebook page. As I said, it is not for the like teachers, but you can also use that facility when the number especially goes high. Now the second is, you know, as an example, IGNO is one of the such organizations. Many organizations are there. We in IGNO is also having a Facebook page through which number of lectures are, I mean, like delivered every day. So it benefits a huge number of students, and it is easy to reach a wider audience. Now the second option is creating a group. Of course, this is the second option. This is how it is done. Many people already know this, how it is done. बट वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू कन्वे इज ये दूसरा ऑप्शन है. वन इज फेसबुक पेज क्रिएशन, सेकेंड इज क्रिएट अ ग्रुप इफ योर नंबर इज वेरी लिमिटेड दैट वे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ इट इज you know 30 or 50 students or maximum 100 students in a classroom, then for such people Facebook group will be more suitable. So in that case people can go with Facebook group option. When the number goes high you can use Facebook page, if the number is less make use of this Facebook group facility. In that case the things that we do in Facebook, the same thing, everything can be almost possible in Facebook group also. Now the third option is Facebook Messenger, which is of course a communication platform just like the Telegram and WhatsApp group. So maybe when we are talking about Facebook group, this could be the third possibility which the teachers can use just to get connected, to send messages in a faster way. So Facebook Messenger could be the third option which the teachers can make use of. The other interesting facility which Facebook released is the workplace. This is also there. I mean, like suppose I am working in an organization where there are 500 employees, 500 all the employees and the students. Suppose it is a college, there will be 1000 or 2000 students, then there will be some 300, 400 employees. So that organization could be considered as a workplace where the number is like maybe 1000, 1500, 2000 and all. So in that case, for such an organization, for such an workplace, Facebook has come up with this facility, creating a workplace. So your colleges, universities, schools, all the organization can make use of this facility also. Whatever I was discussing relating to the Facebook page, Facebook group, then the what we call the messenger, all those facilities are available in Facebook workplace also. So pretty simple. You have to log on to your internet, search for the workplace, then you make an account, then start adding all your employees and students to that workplace. So this is how it is done. So friends, this is how Facebook can be utilized for our teaching learning purpose. These are the four major ways which I would like to share with all the listeners. You can see some of the possibilities, like let me see how it is done. So you can create groups, then you can grab people's attention by streaming your videos. Then you can share the text, images, whatever materials, learning materials which are in digital form, e-content form, all those can be shared. The beauty part is it is integrated to various other tools. Okay, so if you have some materials in your Google Drive, that can be attached easily to your workplace. So these are some of the facilities, major facilities workplace is having. Friends, now the second tool is YouTube. As I said, YouTube is one of the popular tools. Most of the people, teachers, students, all of them make use of the YouTube. Coming to YouTube, how it is accessed? Either you go to YouTube, what we call the YouTube website directly, or the second option is you can, you can go to your email. Then on the right extreme top, you can see some dots. You click on that, then all the Google applications will be coming out. So, usmein se aapko YouTube directly le sakte hain. So, these are the two ways. I mean, like there are other ways also, but major ways are this: either access the Google Gmail, then access the Google, YouTube. Now, coming to the use of YouTube, this is how it is done. How you will sign, pretty simple, nothing to discuss on that. The two ways the teachers can make use of YouTube is, one is uploading your YouTube video. Since the last few months, most of the teachers, students, all of them are attending many seminars, webinars which give some information regarding how they can develop good videos for their students. So you make use of all those tools like Screencast-O-Matic, then Screencastify, ए पावर सॉफ्ट ओ बी एस वॉट एवर टूल यू हैव, फिर उसको एडिट करना आप, फिर उसमें इसको आप यूट्यूब में अपलोड करना, देन इट विल बी एक्सेसिबल टू ए वाइडर ऑडियंस. दिस इज वॉट आई वॉज सेइंग इन द बिगिनिंग. You are not creating content for your students, but it will be easily accessible. It will be equally used by a bigger audience. So if you want to access your materials to be accessed by a bigger audience, a wider audience, then YouTube could be one of the best option. So in that case, you have to upload your video into the YouTube. This is how it is done. See, in your YouTube account, you can see a plus sign here. You click on that, then two options come. Either you upload your video or you click on go live. So there are two options. Either you can give live lectures or you can upload your video. So these are the two major options. Okay, either uploading your ready-made video or you can give live videos. Now to upload video, there is one thing that you have to remember. You have to create a channel first. So this will be the preliminary step that you are going to do when you are going to use the YouTube. You have to start a channel. So that will be your YouTube channel. So all the materials that you are uploading will be through your YouTube channel. So these are the steps that you can follow. This information you have to fill, then your YouTube channel will be ready. You can do all those change settings and everything. Then this is the place which you can use for uploading your video. Okay, when you are uploading your video, messages come. You select the appropriate message, like whether you want to give the YouTube license or standard YouTube standard license or OER license, Creative Commons license, whether you want to make it public, private or unlisted. So you choose appropriate option which is, you know, best available for you, which is best suitable for you. Then you start uploading your videos. So once it is done, if it is not a proper video, you can go to your YouTube videos. Then there is something called a YouTube edit studio. This is the place which you can use for editing your video. So aapka video acha nahi hai, so you can give some animation, you can bring in some text. All those can be done. All those are possible using this facility which we call the YouTube Studio. So you have your YouTube channel first, then start uploading your videos, then make use of this YouTube Studio to edit. Just like other, you know, video creation tools, you have facilities to add images, text, animations, you know, how it has to be started. You can trim your videos, those portions which are not good, that can be removed. All those facilities are available in YouTube Studio. So this is how it will appear like when you are clicking on YouTube Studio. This is what I was saying. Your YouTube Studio video will be here. You can give background music, then you can upload images. All those can be done in YouTube Studio. Friends, Teacher Tube is another third maybe tool, social media tool, which you can of course use. This is again a video repository, just like the YouTube. You can see many things what we call in the Teacher Tube. There are videos, there are text materials, many things are, many teaching learning materials. So this can be accessed by yourself. You can also contribute to what we call the Teacher Tube. So this is how it has to be done. So TeacherTube is nothing but this is a online community for sharing mostly the videos, but as I said, there are various other materials that you can share in your YouTube. Let us see how it is done. Okay, these are the materials, videos, audio, there are collection, there are categories. Okay, so when you go to your TeacherTube, you have to create an account, then you can start uploading your videos, whatever digital materials you have. So this can be accessed by people across the country. So this is the second option if you are going for uploading digital contents. Now third, which I would just mention, those who are teachers, those teachers who are very creative that way, they can make use of this TikTok also. It's not preferable, but those want to have some, make some creative videos, they can of course go with this social media tool. Why? Because there also you can create communities, you can share the information, everything. But in TikTok you can create very small videos which gets attraction of the students. You can use that for that purpose. You can easily get the attraction of the students by creating TikTok videos. There will be some music behind your scenes, then you have to lip sync with that music. This is what is done in TikTok. In many countries, since there are some security issues related with TikTok, few countries have banned, but in India it is available. So maybe you can make use of the, explore the possibilities. So this is a video sharing tool, that's why I have included TikTok, the popular one, maybe YouTube, then TeacherTube, TikTok also. Then coming to the communication social media tools, this is one. Let me see. Okay, this is one, the Twitter, which is very much in use. As I said, if you have large number of audience, large number of students, you can make use of Twitter just like for sharing the information, just like sharing your announcements. So if you want to reach that announcement to a bigger audience, you can of course choose the Twitter. Not only the announcements, if you have created a new video, if you have any audio material, some blog post, all those materials can be, the links of all those materials can be created, that can be shared to your students through the Twitter account. So it is, when we are talking about the definition, it is nothing but it's a microblogging system that allows you to send and receive short posts called tweets. So whatever we are posting in a Twitter will be called as a tweet, which will be a short message. It will not be like a lengthy message like what we see in blog and other WhatsApp messages. So of course you can make use of this facility also, technology. This is how it is done. Then posting messages, you can see when you log into your Twitter, you can see something like a tweet. This is the place where you have to click, then you can start posting your Twitter messages. Friends, colleagues, see, we have the IGNO is also having the Twitter account, and it is getting tweeted all the days. The whenever there is announcement from the IGNO, it is posted in the Twitter account of the IGNO, and it reaches to a wider group of students. So this is, of course, we can make think of. Now coming to the other tool, WhatsApp, which there is nothing to discuss about. Many people are already using that. Most popular maybe communication tool which will help us to share images, audio, video. One thing we have to keep in mind is, like, whenever we are sharing something in WhatsApp, try to share your link. Suppose you have created a video, suppose you have a video in your YouTube account, take the link of that video, then that can be posted in WhatsApp. This serves two purposes. You can share your you can save your bandwidth. Then the second thing, data you can save, of course. Then the third is it reaches to the student. So even the it's a pretty easy way of sharing your teaching learning materials. That you have to keep in mind when you are sharing something in WhatsApp. Now coming to this is one thing which many people may be aware of it, but those who are not aware of this feature, you can use the WhatsApp from your computer also. You go to your WhatsApp, type on WhatsApp, then there is something called WhatsApp web. You can click on that, then this kind of a QR code appears that can be screened from your mobile. Then you can access both WhatsApp from your computer and mobile. So it's easy to work with. When you are working on laptop, you don't have to see all the time your mobile to see the communications information which is coming to your WhatsApp. Friends, in WhatsApp, one of the facilities that you can use is the group creation. You create groups for your classroom. Most of the organization teachers already are doing that, making use of that facilities. There is nothing big in that. The second facility you can use is the broadcast. You have to click on this dot, then create a broadcast list, especially for your students. So all the students will be, you know, included in that broadcast. So it's just like what you know, Twitter. If you want to share some information to your only to your student, you can create the broadcast. Then the information can be shared through the broadcast list. So this is one of the ways maybe you can use. Ye WhatsApp equivalent of Indian equivalent of WhatsApp is the Kaisala, a tool from the Microsoft, which is not that way very popular, but of course those who are not happy with WhatsApp can go with Kaisala also. Whatever features that is available in the WhatsApp, OB Kaisala may be available. So you can share the messages, pictures, documents, videos, everything can be shared. Now the facility of adding too many people, students in WhatsApp, as everyone knows, it is limited to some 256 or 258. When the number goes, your students number goes, people are shifting to Telegram. So this is another popular social media tool which you can use for sharing images, whatever it is there, like digital contents. Apart from that, you can get connected, you can create groups, coordinate, synchronize, all those can be done using the Telegram technology, Telegram tool. Friends, coming to the other, this is how it is done. Just like creating group in WhatsApp, here also we can create a group. This is the place you have to use for creating group. Then the third may be popular is the Instagram, but Instagram is specially designed for sharing the images, like. So those who are very photo creek that way, they are fond of clicking images and all, then maybe they can share it in Instagram. So this is another tool which is also again popular, which you can think of. This is nothing but this is equally accessible in our desktop also. This is the place, this plus button is the place where you have to click to share photos in your Instagram. Mobile, again this plus sign you can sign, addition sign you can sign, usko aap click karna fir aapka photo share karna. So friends, let me give a brief, you know, summary to what I have done. I have given in the beginning Facebook and YouTube, where number of facilities are there. Then I have discussed about some of the communication tools. Then I have discussed about one image sharing software. There are few other. So all those social media tools can be used for creating, sharing and creating the social networks. Now, I was saying in the beginning, I have never met Dr. Somu, but we are friends now because of social media. Suppose I want to access some research paper, which is, you know, very good research paper, but it is available only in some other European or other countries. So if I want to use, again, we have to have some facilities. In that case, people started thinking of creating what we call social media specifically to share their research work and teaching learning material. LinkedIn could be one of such what we call the social media tool, which will help us to create the professional network. LinkedIn, when we are talking about LinkedIn, so both are facilities. One is you can create you know, job post. Then you can search for what we call, you can create the professional groups. Then there are some courses which are owned by the LinkedIn that you can complete. So apart from creating social networks and sharing research paper, there are few more additional facilities which the LinkedIn is providing to the teacher community or the academicians. Now let us see the facilities in LinkedIn. Basically it is a professional network creating group. Let us see. Now see, this is the LinkedIn website. This is how you go to access. This is the place for creating your post. Now just like the Gmail, where we have seen some dots on the right extreme top, LinkedIn may be aapko, you can see such kind of dots. So aap isme click karenge, then all the facilities which are available in LinkedIn will be appearing. Okay, so of which one of the most popular tool social media would be the SlideShare. I'll be talking about SlideShare now. Okay, so LinkedIn is there, then of which SlideShare is one of the most popular social media tool, which will help us to upload the PowerPoint presentation. The presentation that we have created, which we are creating, that can be shared to a wider audience through this SlideShare. So when we are talking about this SlideShare, this could be, you know, described as one of the popular social media tool which will help us to share the presentation. Pretty simple. So most of the teachers, they are using SlideShare. They are making beautiful what we call the presentation, and they are uploading in the SlideShare. This can be accessed by their students and other wider audience. Pretty simple. So friends, you can create, then you can share your PowerPoint presentation. This sharing is the second point which I was saying in the beginning. Social media, either content creation or sharing or the creation of social networks. Now the second tool which will help us to share our research work is ResearchGate. It's a big social media platform. More than 17 million plus members are already there. Many things can be done. You can share, then whatever you are seeing, you know, seeing on the screen, all those can be done using the ResearchGate. Let us see the next. This is how you have to join. Then this is the place for uploading your papers, your research papers. So when you are uploading your research papers, you have to give all the details, where it is published, the number of pages, everything. So all the details will be made available. Friends, one more thing which I wanted to emphasize is when you are uploading your research papers, research work in sites like ResearchGate, LinkedIn, this gets, you know, referred by other people. This is one of the ways you can, you know, increase your H index. So this is always preferable. This always we have to practice, that we have to keep uploading our published papers in the social media tools like ResearchGate and what we call the LinkedIn, so that our H index and the scores goes high. Your citations will also will be more. Otherwise it will be very difficult if it is in hard copy form, printed form. Rarely people, you know, go away with hard copy now, but there are people who prefer hard copy, but many people also use soft copies and they always cite. So when you are uploading your research papers, you can of course make use of this facility, so that H index, then citation, everything will be higher. Now coming to the next, Academia is another social media tool. The number you can see, big number. It's help us to, it helps us to connect with the academicians and the research across the globe. Now this is how you have to access. You go to Academia, then create your account, then upload the papers. The another popular tool is the Google Scholar, which will also help you to upload your research work. Friends, now that was the fourth major thing. We were talking about videos, then communication, then image sites. Then the other important social media tool, another important popular tool, is the Pinterest, which is also very popular that way. See, the Pinterest, how it is helping us. See, when I am searching some material in the internet, the biggest task is millions of, you know, pages the Google search engine will list for us. Okay, millions of papers. Suppose I am searching my name, millions of pages comes out. Even I get confused where I am. I find difficult to locate. But we can't stop now. We have to keep on searching the right paper, right material for us. So we keep on searching. At some point we will find some good material, some website. Then what we can do, we can bookmark that website. We can bookmark, okay. Then it will be easy for us to locate at a later stage. Suppose if you want to bookmark many pages, like 100 pages you are finding very easy, very good for your article or whatever material you are preparing. Then all those has to be bookmarked. Then from bookmark also it will be very difficult sometimes. In that case, to systematically organize your web pages, you can go with Pinterest. Pinterest will help you to systematically organize whatever your web pages that you are looking for. As the name indicates, in Pinterest you will create many pins. Like suppose I am interested in science education, I will create a pin for science education, then another for teacher education. So when I find a good website which is related to science education, I will pin that website into my science education Pinterest account. So I don't have to then all the time search for. I can go to my Pinterest and see that website. So it's very easy. So friends, this is one of the most popular tools to organize your website, social media tool. One, you can use the bookmarking, or else you can go with Pinterest. This is the Pinterest account. You create a, go to Pinterest, create account, then start uploading your materials. Okay, this is how it will look like. You will create a pin. Then this is the second pin, the third pin, this is something related to science education, this is something related to teacher education, this pin is related to higher education. So I'll put all my higher education related website into this pin. Suppose I am visiting NUPA website, I'll put NUPA into this, Delhi University, some other university. So all this will be under this pin. So pretty easy to organize. Friends, now it is blog. There are various ways by which you can use blog. This is nothing but the simplest definition is this is an online journal. There are various ways, okay, you can use. Suppose you are as a teacher, you are giving some assignment to your students. They have to prepare some report. This will, of course, they will prepare in digital form, and they will either send to your what we call the email, or they can post that material in a blog which you have created or the student has created. Then the teacher can use that blog material to grade the student and mark the student. Okay, so this is one of the simplest ways teachers can use. If you want to share your content, create a blog for your classroom in your name. Then if you have some audio materials, if you have audio video materials, any digital content, that can be posted in your blog. Then students will, of course, will easily access that. There are various ways, okay. Either you can post in your WhatsApp or Facebook, or you make use of your blog. So in that case, blog is also a social media. Why? Because you can write in blog, you can read whatever is appearing in other pupils, other teachers' blog. In that way, it is a social media web 2.0 technology. Okay, so this is an online journal. You can see the definition. It's not you know, big deal. This is how you can create. One of the simplest tools you can go is the blogger. Okay, this is a tool of Google. Of course, Google is having multiple number of tools. Blogger is the popular tool which you can use for creating blog. Very simple, both asaan hai. Go to your email, as I was saying in the beginning, fir aap is dot ko click karna, fir aapko sara Google tool aapko milega, fir usme se blogger.com, this is the blogger.com tool. Okay, you click on this, then this kind of a window will appear. Then you start all your like fill all your details, fir aapka blog create hoga. After creating, is tarah ke ek window aapko milega. Then you can start uploading your digital materials, and your blog address can be shared with your students. They can of course watch the materials whatever you are posting. One way, okay. These are the steps which you can follow creating blogs. See, this is how you have to give a blog title. Then you can have some, you can select some default themes. Then your blog will be created like this. If you want to post some new post, blog post, you have to click on this plus button. Then you attach, upload all the materials. Okay, friends. Blogs facilities are there, but if you want to create a multimedia, very beautiful blog where you can attach photos, GIFs, TV shows, links, then dumb jokes, jokes that way, then all those materials like videos, artwork, so it will be, you know, very beautiful to see that way. In a notebook, we will write with paper and pencil. Okay, you can see either black or white paper. White and black pen. This will not look that way very pretty. Okay, maybe this is how we can compare with blog. In a Templar, this is a multi micro blogging social networking site which will help you to create a multimedia blog. Okay, so when you are using many colors, when you are using paint, then the write-up looks more beautiful. In that way, if you want to have a multimedia kind of a blog, this is the most popular social media tool, which is the Tumblr. Okay, you can go to Google, type Tumblr, the Tumblr account will be appearing. Pretty simple. See, this is, even the look and feel is also very beautiful. It's not just like your normal blog, which we create using Blogger, okay. Then you can start, creating, uploading all those materials, video, audio, whatever you have in multimedia form. All those can be uploaded. Pretty simple, friends. Now let us see the next. So of course you can think of the what we call the Tumblr also in place of Blogger. Now coming to the next. So these are some of the materials that you can post. See, text, photo, link, chat, audio, video, all those can be posted in your Tumblr website. Now coming to the image sharing website. See, there are people who, you know, clicks very beautiful photos with mobile. Some use DSLR camera also. Teachers and students sometimes find very difficult if they want to create a beautiful PowerPoint presentation, they sometimes find difficult to get the beautiful photographs, images. Okay, in that case, we can make use of the image sharing social media sites. One of the popular image sharing site is the Flickr. Okay, Flickr you can use basically for sharing your images. So if you have a good, if you have number of various photographs, beautiful photographs with you, you can share it with your friends so that it can be used by a good number of people. Okay, even you can take photographs from that, but be very careful when you are taking photographs about the copyright issues, of which Dr. Gaurav, my colleague, has already given a lecture on that, what all things can be used in your presentation or digital content that you are preparing. So you have to be very careful about the what we call the copyright issues. So Flickr you can make use of. This is how you can start. I have just made the screenshot of what we call the Flickr site. Then you sign in, then start uploading your photographs. This is how it is done. Okay, Flickr. You can search for other people's photographs also. The other part is you can create groups in Flickr also. Okay, suppose you are a man interested in, or a gentle lady interested in what we call cooking, you can create a group where the people who are interested in cooking will form a social network. So the photographs which are related to cooking will be of course posted in that group. So it is easy for you to get, you know, such photographs. So this is the beauty part of what we call the social media tool. So Flickr, you can also upload photos, you can also create what we call the images. The other interesting copyrighted free image sharing website is Pixabay. Maybe you can, some of you can try. You have to click very beautiful pictures with good quality. Okay, your picture has to have a good quality to get uploaded in the Pixabay. You can't, directly upload pictures that way. Picture ko itna quality hona, then only the Pixabay will be accepting your photograph. Okay, then Pixabay, you can take photographs from Pixabay. Okay, I used to do that regularly. Okay, when I am creating my PowerPoints, I use Pixabay because many of the pictures, images which are there in Pixabay, it's copyright free. Okay, so you can use that. So this you can of course think of Pixabay for sharing your image, creating all those. Okay, Then the other place where social media is available is the LMS platforms, learning management system. These are some of the popular learning management systems, very popular. See, when you go to Microsoft Teams, they have integrated many social media tools into their Microsoft Teams LMS. Similarly, you can see the social media integration in other LMS platforms also, like in Google Classroom, Google Groups is there, maybe a kind of a social media tool which you can use for making your students to engage in discussions. So that can be done. So in social media, sorry, you can see the social media integrations in learning management systems also. I have just quoted few popular LMS platforms. Now friends, let us see the next. Skype, of course, now this is the time where we are making use of what we call the Zoom, then Google Meet, then WebEx, then TeamLink. There are many, a big list of what we call the video conferencing tools. Okay, if you know, when many people use that, there can have the problem of issue of internet, then trafficking, everything comes into play when you are taking a video lecture through these kind of video conferencing technologies. So in that case, if you want to have a meeting of some reduced number of students, of course Skype have increased their number, you can make use of Skype also. This is then again a social media tool which you are aware, but you can make, what I am trying to convey is aapko ye bhi use kar sakte hai rather than running behind the Zoom, Google Meet and all. Okay, if your number is very less, you can make use of Skype also. See, recently WhatsApp also update kiya hai, usme now we can have old meeting having 8 number of people, 6 or 8, I think. So WhatsApp also you can use that way. Okay, this is how you have to do. Go to Skype, then create your account, then start meeting. These are some of the facilities like in Skype. Okay, let me see what is there. Audio video calling, messaging, then stream calling, I think all those are possible in Skype. Now friends, let us see the next social media tool, Wiki. Wiki, we have to be very, creative that way. Okay, the best part is whatever we are seeing in Wiki, and the most popular Wiki is the Wikipedia. Wiki is a server program, software application program, which will help the users to, you know, add, edit and modify. This is the definition of Wiki. You can, you know, modify whatever content is available in the Wiki platform. And the most popular Wiki is the Wikipedia. This, all the people are very, aware of. Okay. So, if you want to give some kind of assignment to your students, like you ask your students to bring some information, read some information in the Wiki, and if you want to add some latest information, like for example, let me give a small example, like okay, we were when the Prime Minister or what we call the our ministers change in the cabinet, sometimes people used to edit the Wiki. Okay, the already there will be some information in the Wikipedia, but when the Prime Minister changes, that information has to be added. So that kind of a assignment can be given to your students, just to check the ministers, prime minister name, everything which is there in the website. Okay, if it is not there in the website, you may ask your students to update that content. This is how you have to creatively use the Wikipedia. Then the students will go to Wikipedia, they will create their account, then they will search for the information. If something is wrong, the students will correct that. This is how you can use Wiki. Okay, you have to creatively think of how you can use Wiki. So this is also a popular social media. Why? Because we can, you know, add content, modify the content which is available in the Wikipedia platform. So this is how it is done. Go to Wikipedia, then create a website, account, then you can start uploading content. Okay, friends. Now I think I have reached the end of my presentation. Now there is something more to add from my side. As I said in the beginning, many of these tools are very popular. I have only discussed the popular tools, but I have tried to give some kind of extra information which are available with each of these social media tools. This is number one. Number two, when we are playing so much in the social media, then of course this security privacy issues also come out. Okay, so whenever you are creating an account in any of these social media tools, as a security concern, you create a secondary Gmail. Then when you are creating a secondary Gmail, make sure that the password that you are creating very strong. Then use that secondary Gmail ID for accessing whatever social media tools I was explaining. Okay, and make sure that there are no security issues in any of these social media tools. Whenever there is a threat to your privacy, then the information will be taken by the hackers, then it will create a, you know, big bunch of problems to our personal life. So whenever you are creating new accounts in any social media, don't try to give, you know, your sensitive information. If it is very much, you know, required, then only you give your sensitive information. Otherwise, whenever you are posting something in social media, whether it is Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever kind of social media you are using, be very careful about the kind of information that you are using. Why? Because pretty simple. Just like if you are walking in a mud or sand, it will create the footprint of ours in the mud or sand, okay, and that remains there. It's just like when you are giving some information from your site to social media, definitely it will create a digital footprint of that. Okay, suppose I am feeding my date of birth, I am then that will be there, that footprint, that information will be available somewhere in my social media, somewhere in my computer. Okay, and this can be accessed by the hackers at any time. So be very careful when you are playing with your social media, but don't forget to use the social media tools for your teaching learning purpose. As I said, there are a big list of social media tools available. You choose the best social media tool which is best working for your purpose, and take care of all your security privacy issues, and you can start using the social media tools. Friends, with this small introductory, this small 1 hour lecture, I am, stopping my presentation. If you have any doubt regarding my presentation, if you want to share some information with me, you can use my personal mobile number. My email ID is also there. You are free to. Anyhow, this is the, information of, stage of or age of sharing. So whatever information, few information which I had with me, I had tried to convey with a small group of people. Of course, in fact, it is a big group, these teacher educators. And similarly, you can also share your information, whatever you have. I feel very happy to receive all such information and comments. You're also free to share your comments regarding my lecture so that I can, improve the lecture whenever I give next time. So friends, with this I am concluding my lecture. Once again I thank my friend Dr. Somu, whom we have never seen, we have never met. Only the social media helped us to connect. There was a call from Dr. Somu, that way we got connected. Then I had agreed to give a lecture, and that way we are in a cyberspace where we have lot of connection with lot many people. So let us start growing this connection. Let us make use of such initiatives like the teacher educators group, Bharat Padhe Online, such initiatives, so that it will be helpful for a good number of people. So thanks once again, Teacher Educate. Thanks, Dr. Somu, for this opportunity. Friends, I am winding up. Let me see my Facebook if there are some queries which I can take up. Thank you. Nothing as of now, because many of the things are already knowing. Thank you. Yeah, great. I would like to thank the Dr. Gaurav also, Gaurav Singh, my colleague. I don't know whether he is listening now. Okay, friends, I'm then stopping my presentation. Nothing, no big deal in the chat box. Thank you.